Praise God. Hallelujah. Just tickles me, glory to God, that we are here today together again. Glory, hallelujah. I know you probably say, that's a silly woman. Not really, it's just that I get excited over small things. And you know what, too, I like to say this. And small things are little things. And little as much as when God is in it. Hallelujah. And it's Mother's Day. Praise God. You know, I just want to say this. Happy Mother's Day to all mothers today. Hallelujah. Praise God. And it's just wonderful. It's a wonderful day. It's a day when we can be glad, can be happy, can rejoice that we are women. God made us beautiful. Not only that, God made us for the men. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Adam, that's a long story. Another, that's a sermon that maybe Reverend Mel will preach one day about Adam and Eve. Glory to God. But hallelujah. Amen. You know, I received Happy Mother's Day today. I'm a happy mother. Glory to God. Praise God. I shared you that, you know, I was talking to my daughter this week, and we just like to talk all the time about little girl things. You know, I'm her mother, but sometimes, you know, it's like we speak and we do things together. You know what I'm saying? And that makes us happy. Hallelujah. While I'm talking, I'm just going to reach it. I'm going to reach you something real quick, okay? Anyway, in 19, I believe it was, oh no, actually, this was the year 2006. Glory, hallelujah. Somehow my oldest daughter had managed to sneak this card through to her dad, and they all signed it. And I was, you know, really surprised. Hallelujah. Glory to God. But they say to me, now this is what our daughter says to me in 2006. She says, Mother, as crazy as I think you are, I hope to one day understand the things that I don't, but until then, I will always love you unconditionally. And then she wrote, I admire your strength and hope one day to acquire that too. I thank God for giving me a mother that does not curse and smoke or live any kind of life. Thank you for leading by example. Thank you for loving me too. I don't know if I will be able to enjoy this Mother's Day with you, but if I don't, I hope this will be one year you'll remember for many years to come. And of course, MEMOIR signs it. Miracle Zahn signs it. And Mercy Elaine, my grandchildren, from my oldest daughter, Tia Rica, they all signed it, praise God. And she writes, we love you and thank you. If it weren't for you, we would not be dot, dot, dot with a heart there. Isn't that beautiful? But these are the days, glory to God, hallelujah. And I love the front of it says, on Mother's Day, may you feel that God couldn't bless you more. And throughout the year, may you keep finding that he does. Happy Mother's Day. Praise God. That was from 2006. I keep all of my cards. Because I always have that idea, if someone forget, my kids forget me, I can just read their old cards, okay? And I have one here for my other daughter, Sally. She writes, I thank God as I remember you, Mom. And she referenced me to read 2 Timothy 1 and verse 3. And she goes on to write here, Dear Mom, it is May 2021. Happy Mother's Day. She writes, we love you. Thank you for praying for us. God bless you, Mom. She writes, love Luke and Sally and Ethan and Carter. Yes, Sally's one of my younger daughters. But praise God, I spoke with all my daughters this week. I have one that likes to tell me things of this nature. She's saying, Mom, there's not enough hours in a day. And then she looks at me and she says, I know what you're going to say. You just make the best of each day that comes and do all that you can do. Make yourself a list. And that way, you know, it's like you're sure to get things done. Well, that's when it grows on for them, when it grows on for you too. But let's start. Let them open up here, you know, this morning. Glory to God. God is so good and precious. And I just want to just be in his presence all the time. And I invite you to come along. Hallelujah. So we welcome you this morning. We are here, praise God, from God's Timing Ministry, as you very well know. And not only that, we are a praying team around here. Oh, yes, we are a praying team. And basically, we have a prayer line. Number is 907-452-2922. And then I get great emails from people. And I'll tell you about one in just a bit. But we are at gods.timing.ministry@gmail.com. I love the calls I get. In fact, I have a dear, dear young lady and sister, and it's, I'm going to say her name. I'm going to say Sister Joan. I love it. She made a beautiful comment on Reverend Mel's message last week about about being, how she put it, okay, stubborn as a cow. And it was so beautiful. She writes stuff and she says, well, in listening to the sermon today, I learned about being stubborn as a cow. She says, and I always thought it was stubborn as a mule. Well, my response back to her was, women can be stubborn as cows and men stubborn as mules. And she just laughed. But I enjoy sharing and I enjoy laughing. There's nothing wrong with having a good time. Nothing wrong with laughter. You know, laughter is good medicine for the soul. Try it. If you don't laugh, you know, try it sometime. You'll see. Glory, hallelujah. But you know what? Let us pray. Praise God. Precious Heavenly Father, God, hallelujah. Receive honor and glory and praise, Lord. We come into your presence, Lord God, hallelujah, just waiting, Lord God, like a sponge, Father God. Oh, like a sponge to just soak up from you, Lord God. Father God, to hear your voice, to Father God, to just sit in your presence and just, Father God, and just wait on you. Wait on you, Lord. We love to wait on you in your presence. Hallelujah. For your word tells us that they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles, and that they should run and not be weary, and that they should walk and not faint. Hallelujah. Father God, that's wonderful. We ask you this morning to teach us to wait, Father, upon you. Do we understand everything that happens? They're like, no, Lord, but we know that you do. We know that you hold the future. Glory to God. You hold our future. Hallelujah. You hold every tomorrow that will become today. Glory to God. You hold that in your hand. You, Lord, are our lifeline. You are our future. We give you praise. Help us to be patient, Lord God, this morning. And help us to enjoy today. In the name of Jesus, every mother, Father God, today, let them re-examine themselves. Let me examine myself, Lord God, through your eyes. Look at myself through your eyes. Glory to God. And begin to love myself. It's important to love ourselves with the heart of God, and then we can love others. Glory to God. Praise your holy name. Father God, we just bless you. We ask you just bless us as we go forth in this day. And Father, as we sing praises to you, and just as we bring forth your word, Lord God, and as we encourage people here and there and everywhere, in the name of Jesus, Father God, we give you praise. Give us peace today, Lord God, that passes all understanding. Let us right now forget about ourselves and just concentrate on you. And Father God, let you be our answer, Father God, to everything that we don't understand. But we know, Father God, more than we know, more than anything that's going to tell us, you have the answer. You are the answer. We praise you. We're thankful for this wonderful day, Lord God. And Father, help us all to women to celebrate Mother's Day and help our families to just rejoice with us and enjoy and be glad. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Thank you, Lord God. Praise God. But this is a beautiful song I would like to share. It goes, Jesus, he's a way maker, Jesus. He's a way maker, Jesus. He's a way maker. And one day he made a way for me when my life, it was dark and dreary. Jesus came down and answered my prayer. And one day he made a way for me. Hallelujah. Let me tell you, sing again. Come on, sing with me. Hallelujah. Jesus, he's a way maker. Jesus, he's a way maker. His name is Jesus. He's a way maker. And one day he made a way for me. When my life, it was dark and dreary, Jesus came down, answered my prayer. And one day, Jesus made a way for me. Hallelujah, praise God, just come this way. One day, the sun refused to shine in this simple life of mine. And I pray both night and day that Jesus He would make a way one day. He heard my prayer, and then he answered then and there. But one day, he made a way for me. Come on, let's join us in the chorus. Come on, hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus. He's a way maker, Jesus. He's a way maker, Jesus. He's a way maker. One day, he made a way for me. When my life, it was dark and dreary, Jesus came down and answered my prayer. And one day, he made a way for me. Hallelujah, this. Glory to God. One day, my life will surely end. I'll bid farewell to me. I'll tell him my ups and downs and all evil that was all around. Jesus will say, my child, well done. Your race was hard, but now it's won. For one day, he made a way for me. Come on, let's sing. Come on, sing it. Hallelujah, now. Jesus is a waymaker, Jesus. He's a waymaker. His name is Jesus. He's a waymaker. And one day, he made a way for me. Was dark and dreary. Jesus came down, answered my prayer, and one day he made a way for me. Hallelujah, praise God. Sometimes we start under listening to this. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Sunday, in the presence of the Lord. Monday, receive the rhema word. Tuesday, the enemy showed his face. And a Wednesday, Jesus rebuked him out of your face. Thursday, you sung Amazing Grace. Friday, you gave the Lord the praise. Saturday, the enemy came and raged. And Sunday, you continued to run the race. One day, he heard your prayer, and he answered then and there. For one day, Jesus made a way for you. Maybe he did, but if he didn't, come on, let's sing, come on. Jesus, he's a way maker, Jesus. He's a way maker, Jesus. He's a way maker. And one day, he made a way for me. When my life, it was dark and dreary, Jesus came down, answered my prayer. And one day, he made a way for me. Hallelujah. I believe all of us mothers can sing a similar song of that nature, because when you're raising children, and when you're going through life, when you're trying to be the best wife that you possibly can be, a lot of things happen sometimes. Glory to God. Praise God. And, you know, and that's the thing of time. That's the word. Praise God. Here it goes. Good times. Hallelujah. Good times. Glory to God. Trying times, but trying times, glory to God. All times, God is good. Praise his holy name. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. I'm just thankful to the Lord today. Hallelujah. But this one praise that you just shared with me many years ago, many, many years ago. A senior, her name was Pastor Frieda Triggs, and Pastor, her husband, Phil Triggs. I remember when I used to complain a lot, you know, different complaints about life itself, and she would just begin to sing these beautiful songs to me, you know? And this was one of those songs, and she sang so much, my kids, they were small, they were singing it. Glory to God. But hallelujah, praise God. Jade, my child Jade, she was just singing and singing and singing. People didn't really pay us much attention, but she loved that song. Jesus is a way maker. What does a little baby know about a way making Jesus? But she sang it like a little lady, like she knew it. And it was wonderful. Praise God to see them grow up. And they are all grown now. Our girls and our grandsons, our sons, they're parents themselves today. Hallelujah. So we have a lot to talk about. And we have a lot to laugh about too. Glory to God. When they want to frown a little bit, I take that position as Sister Triggs used to be with me, Pastor Triggs. I just want to sing a song, because sometimes you don't know what to say. Praise God. So you just think to the Lord and let the Lord give you a word for a mother. A mother's job is not easy. It can be very hard sometimes, but praise God. We got to move along here. Glory to God. I just want to say it to you again. Happy Mother's Day. All the mothers out there, praise God. See this beautiful hat here? This hat represents, glory to God, a memorial of my mother-in-law, Linda Lorraine Dennings. Well, Linda Lorraine Strong Dennings. Hallelujah, I say it that way. And also it represents my own dear mother. Hallelujah. Thelma Elaine CHAPMAN-JAMES. Hallelujah. And it's just a memorial, praise God, in the white florals, because that is the indication that they are not with us anymore. They are gone on, but we still, every year, we remember our mothers. Hallelujah. Some say that's crazy. Maybe it is. But that's our way. And praise God. And it's not causing us to do any sin. Hallelujah. To love our mothers. God say love, 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 and love on. Praise God. And that's what we do around here. Praise God. You know, I have here something quick. Because we're gonna move on, praise God, and do some special things here. Hallelujah. I want to say thank you too this morning for Sister Barbie from Unity Ministry with the bag for the women. You know, gave us beautiful gift bags and stuffings to stuff them to pass out to our senior citizens and other women, you know, on this beautiful day. Praise God. And you know what, too? I'm gonna also say thank you too for Sister Sophie Grayson, as I might have shared the story with you a year ago, that, you know, when I was a young mother and my husband was out with the U.S. Navy, and sometimes gone here, gone there, gone a long time, and she would see me and knew me in the Spirit of the Lord. And one day I'm in her garden, and she said to me, she says, I'm going to start with you in a business. I said, I don't need a business. I have my own business already. She said, no, yes, you do. She said, I'm going to teach you how to grow plants. And she said, but that way it would keep you from causing problems for your husband and arguing with your husband. And I thought, who's this lady thing she's talking to? But it's amazing, isn't it? She was an elder woman. That was Sister Sophie. And I remember it so well that her and her husband, Brother Chuck, I remember they loved me like I was there, and my husband too, praise God, and the kids. And I remember when we first met them, at first been in service with them, and I would dance. You probably heard this story. I danced all over their wooden floor, my heels on, praise God. And everybody knew that he didn't like that. But I was the newcomer on the block. And when they tried to look at him like strangely, for him to scold me, and he said, that's my daughter. He said, she's the only one can dance on my floor like that. Isn't it wonderful to have people that love you all over the world? My mother had gone on to eternal home years ago before I met these people, but I'll tell you something. I never felt like I was without my mother, because God put beautiful women in my pathway to be with me and help me and to encourage me through bad days and through raising my children and just everything. I'm just excited, glory to God. People say, you're spoiled. They just don't know, hallelujah. Many have spoiled me, but it spoiled me with love. It's okay to spoil with love, glory, hallelujah. Do you agree? Praise God. I'm sure someone is spoiling you with love. And if they're not, call us in the prayer line. Hallelujah. We'll spoil you with love. Praise God. That's 907-452-2922. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God. Glory to God. I'm just so excited. I'm so excited today. And you know, and it's so, excitement is good. Hallelujah. Woo! When the heart begins to really, you know what I'm saying, like just beat, beat, beat. We're alive, people. We're alive, glory to God. I'm going to sing this cute little praise to our mothers, hallelujah, today. And you know, I'm going to sing it just because I think that sometimes we don't realize sometimes that a lot of things are important more than we know, hallelujah. But first I'm going to share a local announcement. We just got a card here that sought a senior adult living triumphantly on May 14th, which is next Friday night, at 6:30 p.m., at North Pole Assembly of God, they'll be celebrating the 10th anniversary dinner for the season Adults Living Triumphantly. For those who've gone on to their eternal home, glory to God, in the last 10 years, praise God. This is a ministry that the seniors attend. And for many years, even before we became seniors, glory to God, we would go and we would just to be there when our grand jewel was alive. And that was her group. And we would go and they just tell us, well, stay tuned. That's what we did. Hallelujah. We just enjoy it with the seniors. And that's what our mission, anyway. We work with the seniors and we try to feed the seniors. We go and just help them enjoy their day, visit with them. Hallelujah. It's wonderful. Glory to God. I love having lots of, you know, the seniors around. Praise God. I love to hear their stories. Hallelujah. They add to me. Hallelujah. Praise God. Do you want somebody to add to you? Hallelujah. Why don't you try that? If you don't do anything in the mission, the ministry, try calling a senior and loving on one of them. Praise God, or him or her. Try, you know what I'm saying, like I'm striking a conversation. Hallelujah, because some of them are very lonely. They don't have anyone. Some of them are the last of their family. Hallelujah, all gone home. They're in their 90s and 100 years old. That's pretty long, huh? But praise God, I'm going on. But anyway, but that's going to be May 14th, 2021 at 6:30 p.m. That's next Friday. That's for local Fairbanks. Wish you all out there could go too. You really enjoy it. Hallelujah. And then we have here an announcement from Bible Baptist Church here in Fairbanks. And what you can do, locals, if you don't get the information, you can always call us on the prayer line and we can give you further. But anyway, it is scheduled for today, believe it or not. And basically, it's going to be from 12:30 to 2:30 p.m. today. Hallelujah. And so it's like the family. It's a family carnival. Praise God. It's parents and the children. Go and enjoy. Praise God. If you like the rides, they say they have rides. Lots of food. Glory to God. That sounds real good to me. But, you know, unfortunately, our service, I'm going to say we'll be in service at that time today too as well. But glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Here's a neat little song I want to sing that my kids used to sing when they were babies. Hallelujah. But I changed the words around. Hallelujah. And I made it to be a Mother's Day praise today. Let's just pull it. I wrote it down so I got to pull it out. In a few minutes here, Reverend Mel is getting ready to blow us away over there with the hallelujah, infallible glory to God. Ooh, word of God. Hallelujah. But this one praise here is beautiful. And I'm going to sing it. This is a dedication to the mothers out there. Hallelujah. Because we do endure. But the Bible tells us too that and tells us all, he who has endured into the end shall be saved. Glory to God. Isn't that wonderful? But it goes like this. I'm going to serenade you today, okay? Praise God. Hallelujah. And you go forth and serenade some other mother. Mothers, I'm talking to you. And fathers, if you're listening, you serenade mom today. Praise God. Serenade your wives, the mother of your children. Praise God. Here goes. Be careful, dear moms, what you do. Be careful, dear moms, what you do. For the Father up above, he is looking down with love. So be careful, dear moms, what you do. Be careful, dear moms, where you go. Be careful, dear moms, where you go. For the devil is waiting to knock you down below. So be careful, dear moms, where you go. Be careful, dear moms, what you hear. Be careful, dear mom, what you hear. For the devil tell lies, and you should not be surprised. Be careful, dear mom, what you hear. Be careful, dear mom, what you say. Be careful, dear mom, what you say. Be careful, dear moms, for the devil speak words lies. May mess up your good day. So be careful, dear mom, what you say. Let me try that again. Praise God, it goes. Be careful, dear mom, what you say. Be careful, dear mom, what you say. For the devil speaks words that may mess up your good day. So be careful, dear mom, what you say. Father of the sun, he is looking down in love. So be careful, little mom, what you do, what you go, what you do, what you say. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Happy Mother's Day. Praise God. At this point, I'm going to bring forth to you, hallelujah, something probably new to you, Reverend Mel. For those who know him, glory to God. Reverend Mel, praise God. Hallelujah. Come to greet you again. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Praise God.
Yes, hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank glory to God.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Heavenly Father, for another wonderful day, Lord God, that we can worship you, Heavenly Father, in spirit and in truth, Lord God.
Heavenly Father,
we thank you for this very special day called Mother's Day, Lord God. I ask for a special blessing, Lord God, an anointing placed upon mothers, Lord
God.
In Jesus' precious name we
pray. Glory to God. Amen.
Good morning. It's a beautiful day outside for celebration. And speaking of celebration, happy Mother's Day.
Praise God.
To all of the mothers out there, here, near, and far.
Hallelujah.
My wife is a mother of our children. Other people's children. She even mothers grown-up people, women and men, and sometimes she acts like she is my mother until I rise up in authority and put her back in her place. Like the Bible says, the rod of correction is for the back of the unlearned.
Okay. Really? Hallelujah.
But I like to live in peace. I'm a lover, not a fighter. So.
Hallelujah. That he is.
So our message today is, where is God times of conflict within the family?
Where is God? Yes.
A lot of people ask that.
Glory to God.
In veterans' hospitals today,
praise God,
there are many patients who are still suffering effects of wounds received from the war.
Thank you, Jesus.
My father is one of them. He was a Vietnam veteran. And he still suffers from Vietnam.
Thank you, Jesus.
Years and years later. Hallelujah. This is one of the war's tragedies. Even when the shooting stops, many continue to bear physical and emotional scars.
Hallelujah.
Some of them for the rest of their life, like my father. There are other types of casualties, though, that are just as tragic.
Thank you, Jesus.
They are the men, women, and children who have been scarred by family conflicts.
Praise God.
Some wounds may not be deep and may heal soon, while other ones will last a lifetime.
Yes.
God desires to heal those wounds.
Yes, he does.
Those involved are willing to let him. For reconciliation to take place,
praise God,
everyone involved must be willing to do their part.
Yes.
Stubborn pride will keep restoration from taking place.
Mm.
Please turn with me in your Bibles to Genesis 25, and we're going to read from 21 to 26.
Praise Jesus.
Honey, can you please read that this morning?
You know what? Praise God. I'm going to step right here. I'm going to tip right here. Yeah. Praise God. Genesis.
So while she gets the Bible this morning, let me cover real quickly. We're going to be talking about a mother named Rebecca.
Thank you, Jesus.
And it is a time of conflict.
Hallelujah.
A time of conflict. As we often see in a lot of our families' lives, there is conflict. Amen. That takes place within our families.
Praise God.
And a lot of it stays there for years and years and years. Amen.
Precious Jesus.
And so.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Can it just be 1 minute while she pulls up the Bible?
Okay, thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Okay, that was
Genesis 25.
Praise God. He caught me off guard there. Glory to God.
Verses 21 through
26. Okay,
21 through 26.
Praise God. Genesis 25, 21 through 26. Praise God. Here we are. And Isaac entreated the Lord for his wife, because she was barren. And the Lord was entreated of him, and Rebekah his wife conceived. Hallelujah. And the children struggled together within her, and she said, if it be so, why am I thus? And she went to inquire of the Lord. And the Lord said unto her, two nations are in thy womb, and two manner of people shall be separated from thy bowels, and the one shall be stronger than the other people, and the elder shall serve the younger. And when her days to be delivered were fulfilled, behold, there were twins in her womb. And the first came out red, all over like an hairy garment, and they called his name Esau. And after that came his brother out, and his hand took hold on Esau's heel, and his name was called Jacob. And Isaac was 80 years old when she bare him. While I'm at it, I'm going to going to read the other scripture for the morning. Is it okay?
Yeah, okay. Please.
Praise God. I was on this, I was reading this here earlier, but Genesis 25, 27, which is kind of like, you know, sometime after that. But then the boys grew, and Esau was a cunning hunter, a man of the field, and Jacob was a plain man dwelling in tents. Verse 28 says, and Isaac loved Esau because he did eat of his venison, and Rebekah loved Jacob. And Jacob said, sought pottage. And Esau came from the field, and he was faint. And Esau said to Jacob, feed me, I pray thee, with that same red pottage, for I am faint. Therefore was this name called Edom. And Jacob said, sell me this day thy birthright. And Esau said, behold, I am at the point of death. And what profit shall this birthright do for me? And Jacob said, swear to me this day. And he sware to him, and he sold his birthright unto Jacob. Then Jacob gave Esau bread and pottage of lentils, and he did eat and drink and rose up and went his way. Thus Esau despised his birthright. Now we go to Genesis 27 and 30, first, fourth verse, and the 35th and the 41st. Let me read them. And when Esau heard the words of his father, he cried with a great and exceeding bitter cry, and said unto his father, bless me, even me also, O father. And he said, thy brother came with subtlety, and has taken away thy blessing. And Esau hated Jacob because of the blessing therewith. His father blessed him. And Esau said in his heart, the days of mourning for my father are at hand. Then will I slay my brother Jacob? And we go here to the Genesis 33 and 4. Praise God. And Esau ran to meet him and embraced him and fell on his neck and kissed him, and they wept. And he said, what meanest thou by all this drove which I met? And he said, these are to find grace in the sight of my Lord. And Esau said, I have enough, my brother. Keep that thou hast unto thyself. And Jacob said, nay, I pray thee, if now I have found grace in thy sight, then receive my present at my hand, for therefore I have seen the face, I have seen thy face, as though I have seen the face of God, and thou wast pleased with me. Take, I pray thee, my blessing that is brought to me, because God has dealt graciously with me, and because I have enough. And he urged him, and he took it. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Praise God.
Yes, a time of conflict.
Thank you, Jesus.
Rebecca's husband was Isaac.
Hallelujah.
Whose mother was Sarah, or Sarai, and father was Abraham.
Thank you, God.
In the Old Testament, childness was viewed as a disgrace.
Thank you, Jesus.
Isaac and Rebecca's childlessness was especially troubling, since Isaac was the promised son of Abraham.
Yes.
And the one through whom God's promise to Abraham would be fulfilled.
Yes, hallelujah.
Isaac and Rebecca had been married almost 20 years. Before they had children. 20 years. Imagine that.
Thank you, Jesus.
Sometimes during the 20 years, though, Isaac began seeking the Lord.
Yes.
He understood it was important to seek God during conflict, during difficult times. Abraham had also faced childlessness, but we have no scriptural record of Abraham seeking God for Sarah. Isaac had seen the trouble that Ishmael had caused, and perhaps he did not want to do anything that would cause further trouble. He needed an answer from God. In the same way, God has an answer for us during our difficult times.
Yes, hallelujah.
When we turn to him, he will help us understand what we are experiencing and help us face our difficulties.
Yes.
God answered Isaac's prayer, and Rebecca conceived.
Praise Jesus.
Possibly there were physical causes for Rebecca's inability to conceive.
Yes, thank you, Jesus.
But we always have to remember that God is the giver of life.
Yes.
And God healed her.
Praise God.
Rebecca became disturbed over the unusual movement in her womb.
Thank you,
as my wife read earlier. When she asked God about this, God revealed to her she would have twin sons.
Yes, Jesus.
These sons would head two different nations.
Yes.
The struggle she was feeling indicated the conflict that would develop between her sons and their prosperity. Even though Jacob and Esau were twins, the one who was born first was considered the elder or older and entitled to the rights of the firstborn. However, in the case of Isaac and Rebekah's twin sons, the older would serve the younger.
Yes.
The twin was born first, the twin that was born first got his name,
thank
Esau,
you,
or Harry. The term Harry from his unusual amount of body hair. This must have been pretty strange to see a baby born. It's all hairy. Amen. A strange thing happened as the second twin was being born that had a prophetic significance. He caught hold of his brother's heel as if to trip him or pull him back in. Something that was to happen late in later years of their lives. Mm-hmm. Perhaps his parents named him Jacob or heel catcher in amusement. But that did not turn to sorrow. Time to sell the birthright. Yes. The Bible admits the younger years of Esau and Jacob and continues the story in their adult life. We see that their temperaments were totally different, but this did not need to cause conflict. Yes. Their deeper differences laid in their contrasting views of life. Yes. And we see that in our families. I have three brothers and all of us have a different view on life on things. But it doesn't have to cause conflict. Esau was an outdoor man who loved the thrill of game hunting. Some saw him as a man interested only in gratifying fleshly desires. Let me go kill that buck today. Amen. Whereas Jacob was seen as a plain man, meaning that he was quiet, mild-mannered. He preferred staying home and attending to his duties. Despite his faults, Jacob would develop an appreciation for the spiritual.
Thank you, Jesus.
According to Genesis 25:27, Isaac favored Esau because he enjoyed the venison that Esau brought him. Whereas Rebekah may have been repelled by Esau's obsession with hunting. She enjoyed the comfort of Jacob's company because he was always home. Partiality by parents is harmful to family unity.
Amen.
The kind of favoritism displayed by Isaac and Rebekah sets the stage for future heartache and bitter feelings.
Yeah.
Parents who show partiality to one child often cannot see the good in the other child. Mm. And we see that all the time in different families. This may cause parents to treat their children unfairly. Sometimes driving children not only away from home, but away from God.
Yes.
The birthright was an important part of passing the estate to one's children. In those days, in his inheritance, the eldest son, the one with the birthright, received a double portion of the estate.
Yes.
This son also became the head of the family,
mm-hmm.
and the line would continue through him. If Rebekah had told Jacob he would one day have this birthright, then what happened in verses 29 through 34 was not an afterthought. Jacob's scheme would have been well planned and awaited the opportune moment.
Yes.
This moment came when Esau returned from hunting one day. He was famished and felt that he was at the point of death. The smell of Jacob's pottage was enticing. He wanted it quickly. Esau's request can be translated literally, "Give me some of that red stuff to gulp down." For I am famished. His hunger for the red pottage earned Esau the nickname Edom, meaning red. His descendants would be called Edomites and were enemies of Jacob's descendants. Jacob's methods were unworthy, to say the least, but they show his appreciation for the value of the birthright. God, though, would have seen to it that Jacob received it without resorting to such trickery and tactics. Esau could think only of his physical hunger. At that moment, nothing spiritual was in his mind. He despised his birthright, meaning that he treated it with contempt. For the moment Jacob had what he had been wanting, Esau had sold his birthright for a bowl of pottage.
Mm.
But Jacob's euphoria would not last. He had sown seeds of bitterness and hate that would divide and disrupt the family in days to come.
Yeah.
Now a time of deception. According to Genesis 27, it happened many years after Esau had sold his birthright to Jacob. Both men were past 40 years of age. Jacob and Rebekah had devised a plan to deceive Isaac. Jacob had barely left his father's tent when Esau returned from hunting with the meal he had prepared for Isaac in order to get his blessing. The blessing Esau hoped to receive The blessing for the firstborn was somewhat like an oval or an oral will made by a father who knew his death was near. Mm. They didn't write it down. Back then, the actual father laid his hands on the eldest son and gave him the birthright blessing. Amen. The birthright blessing. In this blessing, the father officially presented all of the provisions of the birthright to his son. Isaac's blessing on Jacob was prophetic.
Yes,
Lord. It confirmed what God had told Rebecca before the twins were born, that the younger would rule over the elder.
Yes.
This blessing was considered an oath before the Lord and was therefore irrevocable.
Yes.
Jacob and Rebecca knew this, but even though the scheme was certain to be found out, the blessing would still be Jacob's.
Yes, amen.
Isaac was stunned when he learned how he had been deceived. Mm. Yet he knew he could not change what had been done.
That's right.
Esau's loud cries were those of one who has thrown away something very valuable and then realized what he's done. The birthright meant nothing to Esau when he was hungry.
Mm.
Nothing. He was willing to trade it all to satisfy his hunger. He realized his folly too late.
Yes.
Just like we do sometimes.
We do it. Hallelujah.
Amen. When Isaac explained to Esau that Jacob had come with subtlety and taken away the blessing, Esau exploded in fierce anger.
Mm.
He said Jacob had been named correctly. He was a supplanter, a heel catcher, a schemer. In desperation, Esau tried to force some kind of blessing from his trembling father. Isaac and Rebekah were partly to blame for this dissension between Jacob and Esau.
Father and mother.
Neither Isaac nor Rebekah were upright in their action.
Mm.
Both showed favoritism to their sons.
Yes.
In addition, Rebekah was deceitful in her plan to get the blessing for Jacob. If both parents had discussed God's prophecy concerning their sons and asked God how he was going to fulfill it, they could have avoided the strife their deceptiveness and strong wills actually caused upon that family.
Mm-hmm.
It is important for parents to discuss and pray about their children's future.
Yes, Lord Jesus.
As parents become sensitive to what God wants to accomplish through their children, they can direct their children according to God's plan.
Yes.
Not what they want. But if parents try to push their own desires on their children, they can hinder what God wants to do through their children.
Glory, hallelujah. Mm, true.
So now we come to, in this story, a time of revenge. Isaac's blessing of Jacob included everything that would have made him prosperous and successful. There was nothing left that he could give to Esau to satisfy Esau. But Esau cried out anyways for a blessing. When Esau sold his birthright to Jacob, he thought he was going to die. The thing he thought he would never need became the most important thing in his life.
Yes, praise Jesus.
But his lack of concern for the important things in life cost him dearly.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Isaac could not do much for Esau.
Gracious Jesus.
In answer to his son's frantic pleas, the father did the best he could.
Yes.
He did. His blessings from his father would be considered a curse. Esau would live in an environment where the soil would not produce for it.
Mm-mm.
He would also live by the sword. He would survive only by fighting.
Mm-hmm.
Worst of all, Esau would be his brother's servant.
Mm-mm.
However, the time would come when he and his descendants would break free from Jacob's domination.
Yeah, the time.
This was fulfilled during the reign of Jeroboam, when the Edomites, Esau's prosperity, finally broke free from Israel's rule, according to 2 Kings chapter 8, verses 20 through 22.
Mm-hmm.
Esau knew that what his father had said could hardly be considered a blessing. He didn't comfort him because he couldn't comfort him because the blessing had been stolen. His reaction to this blessing was bitter hatred. While his father was living, he knew Isaac's days were numbered.
Yes.
So Esau comforted himself by planning to kill Jacob when the mourning period for his father had ended.
Yes.
But finally, we come to a time of healing in this story.
Mm-hmm.
A time of healing. After Jacob spent 20 years away from Esau, Jacob was afraid to meet his brother. He divided his family into two companies. He said if Esau and his men killed one group, at least the others might escape.
Mm-hmm.
Jacob's spiritual transformation was important to his reconciliation with his brother.
Yes.
Esau had 400 men with him, the Bible says. Jacob assumed that Esau was bent on revenge.
Yes.
But this was a different Jacob, for he had experienced a life-changing confrontation with God the night before.
Praise God, praise God.
He knew that he had no choice but to meet with his brother face to face. Esau, though he did not greet Jacob in anger.
Mm-hmm.
The time of reconciliation finally comes in this story. He welcomed his brother. When we are right with God, we often discover that he has already smoothed out our difficult relationships.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen. He's already taken care of it for us.
Thank you, God.
There is no better example than Jacob's experience than his meeting with his brother Esau.
That's right.
Esau was amazed at the large number of people that Jacob had with him. Humbly, Jacob gave God the glory for his family.
Gracious Jesus.
Then the women, the mothers and the children followed Jacob's example and bowed down before Esau.
Thank you, Jesus.
Becoming participants in the reconciliation.
Praise God.
Earlier, Jacob and Esau were only concerned with getting the birthright and the material wealth it provided.
Mm-hmm.
Because God had dealt with both of these brothers, they were no longer greedy.
No. Thank you, God.
Jacob willingly gave his flocks to his brother. Esau did not want Jacob's herds and only took them because Jacob insisted.
Mm-hmm.
When God truly touches our lives, we will not let material possessions come between us and those we love.
No, no.
We will willingly share with others.
We will.
God intended for families to love each other and live in harmony. When this happens, it is a joy for family members to be together.
Yes, thank you, God.
But if this love and harmony does not exist, family times can be very stressful.
Hallelujah.
Because family members are human, problems may arise at times.
That's
even in
right.
Christian homes.
Mm.
However, we need to do everything in our power to make sure those situations are resolved quickly.
That's right.
They cannot be allowed to grow and divide the family. For the one thing that God instituted upon this earth that the devil has been trying to destroy since the beginning of time was family. It is family.
Family.
We can avoid much of the conflict in our home by praying for wisdom and dealing with our children.
Yes, hallelujah.
God knows what is best for each of our children, and can help you direct their lives.
Yes, that will direct their lives.
Ask God.
We have to ask Him.
Ask God to keep you from showing favoritism with your children.
We don't want to show favoritism with our children, mothers, fathers too.
None. While some of your children may be easier to relate to, treating some of them or any of them unfairly can result in strife.
Yes.
Allow God's Spirit to help you relate to each one of them as He wants you to.
He will help us.
Yes. Perhaps you're experiencing turmoil, conflict between your children. God can help you bring them together in reconciliation.
Mm-hmm.
Pray that each person involved in that strife will be drawn closer to God. Ask the Holy Spirit to melt any resistance to reconciliation. Then allow God to use you as a peacemaker and bring healing to the conflict.
Praise God.
The joy and peace that you develop between your family members will bring enjoyment to your family gatherings.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise God.
Christmas will be Christmas again. Amen.
Praise
when we
God.
Can sit around and enjoy the birth of Jesus Christ, amen?
Praise God.
With our family.
Thank you, Jesus.
So right now, let's do a toast to mothers, amen?
Praise God.
A toast to mothers.
Thank you, Jesus. To my mother.
And to my mother, amen?
Praise God.
Thank you, Jesus.
and to all of you mothers here, near, and far. Glory to God.
Yes. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Mothers are so wonderful. They're such an important part of our families.
Praise God.
Without mothers, where would we be? Amen. Where would we be?
Thank you, Jesus.
So please close your eyes right now and listen to the words of this song.
Precious.
Called The Altar.
Hallelujah.
Which speaks of reconciling to God.
Yes, thank you, God.
Thank you, Jesus. I am without one plea. Oh God, thy blood was shed for me. And let the beast come to thee, O Lamb of God.
Service is nearing an end. The choir is singing, just as I am. Now as the old song is played,
hallelujah, praise God.
People at the altar are kneeling down to pray. Some are finding mercy, forgiveness for their sins. Some are fighting battles, and they're struggling to win. The time has come to give them to the Lord. That's what this altar is for. That's what this altar is for.
Yes, it is.
You don't have to carry your burdens anymore.
No.
But there's a light in the darkness.
And there's a love that's true.
Jesus is waiting. He is waiting here for you. Go quickly now. Before they close the door. That's what this altar is for.
Praise God, thank you, Jesus.
A father is praying with his son.
Oh, thank you, Jesus.
A mother kneels beside them, thanking God they've come. An old man is standing there in tears, giving up a part of him that he's held back for years. Hearts are being broken, lives are being changed. Those who call upon him, it will never be the same. The time has come to give them to the Lord.
Jesus.
That's what this altar is for. That's what this altar is for. You don't have to carry those burdens anymore. There's a light in the darkness, and there's a love that's true. Jesus is waiting, he's waiting here for you. Go quickly now, before they close the door.
Hallelujah.
That's what this altar is for. That's what this altar is for.
Yes, it is. Hallelujah.
You don't have to carry those burdens anymore.
glow. But there's a light in the darkness, and there's a love that's true. Jesus is waiting, he is waiting here for you.
Hallelujah.
Go quickly now, before they close the door. You can give your burdens to the Lord. That's what this altar is for.
Hallelujah, that beautiful praise, God. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
The altar.
Thank you. Hallelujah.
Praise
thank
God.
You.
Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, yes, hallelujah. Right. Reconciliation starts at the altar.
Yes.
Hallelujah, it's the altar.
It's the altar.
Hallelujah.
God. Hallelujah. Praise God,
thank
Father
you,
God.
Jesus.
We just give you glory.
Thank
God.
You, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Happy wonderful. Mother's Day. Hallelujah.
Praise God. Wasn't that a thank wonderful, you. Praise God, message presented and brought forth by Reverend Mel today to you, to myself. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord Jesus. I get excited when I get excited. Glory to God. A lot of times I just forget, hallelujah, I get caught up in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, and just forget what I'm doing. You know what I'm saying? Hallelujah. Oh, I forget, glory to God, what I'm supposed to be doing, rather, hallelujah. Praise his holy name. But you know what? That's called humans. Hallelujah. God, your presence is so different than any other presence, hallelujah. And when you're there, glory to God, it's like all the plans that you've made seem like, it's like those plans just go kaput, hallelujah. Because now you're on a different, glory to God, you're in a different, glory to God, like, mode of doing things. Hallelujah. I just love the Lord how he does that to us. He takes us out of ourselves and brings us into himself. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I just like to just excite you. I like to encourage you. I like to just in a day let you know, glory to God, that we are all in this walk together. We're in this life together, glory to God. And it's gonna be all right. You can make mistakes all day long, glory to God. Do you know that God knows you're not perfect? But guess this, but that he's in the business of perfecting the saints. God is in the business of perfecting us, hallelujah. And so we don't have to be perfect, glory to God. We don't have to put on no act, no facade. When we make mistakes, glory to God, it's all right because we're humans. But you know what God is most important with us? His most important with us is this, that we love him, hallelujah. He knows that our hearts are sincere for him, glory to God. He knows we are sold out for him, hallelujah. And the Lord doesn't look at the small things, hallelujah. Praise God. In some ways, you know, it is that he's the father of the fatherless. Glory to God. But he's also the mother of the motherless. Hallelujah. And he loves us. Glory to God. Praise God. I want to say that. And as our mothers love us, our fathers love their children. Praise God. Now, I know you probably say that, oh, when I was a child, my parents, they never did anything. My mother didn't care about me, blah, 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 blah. And I get the excuse to be sad. I don't want to be happy. And I don't want no one else to be happy. But listen up. That's a cop out. And right now, I'm going to pray. If you've had a bad childhood, if you think so, you've been affected by something your mother have done and it affecting you, and you can't be the mother that you were called by God to be, let us pray, because you know what? There is an answer to your dilemma. Praise God. And don't let life pass you by. Don't begin to think that, well, my mother wasn't good to me, so I can't be good to my kid. I refuse to. No. No, there are so many kids out there who don't have parents. And they're looking to you and me. Praise God. They're looking to my husband, your husband. Glory to God. Men, listen up. It's Mother's Day, yes, but there are men out there who are looking, they have nobody, they're alone. We can all be witnesses. That's what God called us to. God, he tells us, go ye into the world and preach the gospel to every creature. And mothers, hallelujah, that means us too. We have to go and we have to minister to the young mothers, hallelujah, glory to God, to let them see, let them understand that we know it's not easy. We've been through that. We are their testimony, glory to God. We are their witness, hallelujah, for God. And as I pray right now, if you have any issues today on any level, whether you are, you know, mother, whether you are father, whether you are a teenager, whoever you're viewing and whatever your situation, I'm praying right now in the name of Jesus. Because that's what this altar is for. We come before God and we pour out. I pray in the name of Jesus that God heal any and every broken heart today. In the name of Jesus, I pray that God will cause you to see yourself differently than you've been looking and you've seen yourself. I pray that God give you peace to understand that you are here for a purpose. I pray that God gives you joy, hallelujah, and cause you to rejoice over the things that you've gone through, hallelujah, only to learn that those things for such a time as this, glory to God, they had to take place because it brings you to the fullness, glory to God, of the ministry of Jesus Christ, understanding the feeling of other people, glory to God, being able to outreach people, glory to God, and tell them, I know where you are. I've been there. I've done that, glory to God. I pray today that the Lord bless you and make him and cause you to excel beyond the things that you that cause you to fall down in the dumps a lot and to be a money grubber, or argumentative, or whine, moan, wrong, complain about. Hallelujah. I pray God give you the gift of rejoicing, that you are rejoicing and that you will come into the presence of others and lead them into rejoicing in the name of Jesus. Today I pray for mothers who are down and out for the loss of their children. In this last year, I know that happened in many families. I pray for you that you would know that the Lord, hallelujah, has a plan for you still. And oh, he will heal your broken, wounded heart. In the name of Jesus, he will do it. And I pray that God will just touch you right where it hurts at and cause that hurt to move away. In the name of Jesus. Right now, I bind up every evil demon that tries to provoke you to hang out there and to just feel like you have to die because of the child, or you have to die because of the husband, or you have to die because of a friend. No, it's time to live. In the name of Jesus, I pray that God will make it real to you, make it live to you, and that he will cause you, persuade you to come into his presence and desire him. And if you're out there unsaved today, I was speaking of the people in the faith, because some of the people in the faith get carried away. But if you are not in the faith, you are not born again, I pray right now in the name of Jesus that you too, that you will come to know Jesus, the first Lord and Savior, and that you will continue to get on your knees and pray and just talk like you're talking to me. Talk like you're talking to your neighbor. Lord, but only reverence him. I'm so sorry for my sins. I know I've lived against you, and I just ask you, Lord, to help me, Father God, to know, Father God, that you are what I've been looking for, here and there and everywhere, and that I've looked in the wrong places. Oh, I've looked here, I've looked there, I looked high, you know, but Father, help me to look to you, Father God, right now, Father God, help me to repent of my sin, and help me, Father God, oh, to come forth and to be in your family, and that way I can in time for my children, Father God, my husband, Father God, we can all become a part of your family and rejoice and be glad in the name of Jesus. And help me, Lord, to be the best mother that I can be according to your word. In Jesus' name, Father, I love you and I praise you, Lord, today. Just cry out to him. It's okay. We're in God's presence. We can cry out to our Father. He's our Father who art in heaven, all the way be his name. His kingdom come, his will be done on earth as it is in heaven. He will give us this day our daily bread, and he will forgive us our debts, and we will forgive our debtors. He will lead us not into temptation, but he will deliver us from evil. For thine, this kingdom is God's kingdom. The power and the glory and all belongs to him. And we worship and praise him in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Father God, we praise and we thank you and love you. Always be glorified. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God bless you all. Have a wonderful day. Salute your mothers. Glory to God. And mothers, hallelujah. Just eat it up and like a sponge, suck it up. Hallelujah. And just do it. Hallelujah. Party. Hallelujah. Mother, come on. Happy Mother's Day. Happy Mother's Day. Happy Mother's Day to you. Happy Mother's Day.